Hello everyone and welcome. My name is Ricky Boleto. This is the latest deepfake technology that I am showing you.
Do you know what a deepfake is?
Can you believe this is not really me?
I'm taking a closer look to find out what they are and why someone might want to make one.
And this video is not real.
First up, let's talk to the BBC's disinformation expert, Mariana Spring.
Thank you so much for chatting to Newsround. You are very busy trying to identify what's real and what isn't. What is a deepfake?
Deepfakes are basically any kind of content. So that might be a picture, it might be a video, it might be an audio clip that has been created using AI technology. And AI stands for artificial intelligence. So it's been created from scratch. It's fake, it's not real, but often these kinds of pictures, videos, clips can be really quite convincing.
I've come to the University of Southampton to speak to Dr. Jennifer Williams.
How easy is it to make deepfakes?
Well, it's becoming a lot easier than it used to be. Nowadays, there's a lot of different open source online tools that you can get for free, and all you need is an image and a bit of audio, and you can create a deepfake.
So you've created two deepfakes of me here. Can we listen to this one?
Hello everyone and welcome. My name is Ricky Boleto. This is the latest deepfake technology that I am showing you.
So it sounds like me. I can see some of the movements on the face are repetitive, hasn't quite pronounced my name properly, but this is something that was created within a few minutes. It's actually quite good, isn't it?
It used to be that we needed hours of your voice in order to create a clone, but nowadays, because the advances in artificial intelligence, we only need about 10 seconds.
So how does it work? How do you turn a picture of me into a talking video that even sounds like me?
So there's actually two parts to making a deepfake like this. One is dealing with the image of your face, and the other is dealing with your voice.
So why are there all these different triangles and squares on my face?
So this shows how we're going to take your photo and make it come to life. The first thing we want to do is identify your facial landmarks. So this includes things like your eyebrows, your eyes, your nose, and your mouth. The artificial intelligence system then generates all the different types of ways that your face can move left and right, up and down, and then it picks the best one to match the audio.
This is not really me.
So Ricky, I wanted to show you a deepfake of myself that I made using the same technology that we deepfaked you with.
Okay, let's have a look.
Hello, I am not Jennifer Williams, and this video is not real.
I mean, some videos don't look quite right. I mean, you sound like you, but you certainly look a bit strange, if you don't mind me saying, and you don't look like that in real life. What's going on here?
So you saw the way my face had some glitches as I was turning my chin from left to right, and then the way my eyes are looking at the camera, this eye is looking at the camera, but this eye is not.
And this video is not real.
Why would someone want to create a deepfake?
So it tends to be used in political situations often. So maybe it's a president or a prime minister or a mayor, and they might be deepfaked so that they say something or do something that people that don't like them would want them to be caught saying or doing. When it comes to world leaders saying things or doing things that they never said, that is a problem because we've got lots of elections, we've got lots of stuff going on all across the world, and it can affect how people vote or what they decide when it comes to elections and just what people think about different political leaders based on something that's not true rather than the evidence and the facts.
But there are also some benefits to deepfake tech.
So if someone has lost their voice due to a disability, we might want to recreate their voice, and we can give them their voice back using the same technology that creates deepfakes.
And this video is not real.
Creating a good deepfake is a complex and challenging process that often requires advanced technical skill. But free apps and websites are getting better all the time. The worry is that in the wrong hands, these videos could spread information that's not true and harmful.